Hi, and thank you so much for joining us today. Let me ask you a question. Do you or somebody you know have a CAT scan or a PET scan or an MRI that is coming up in the next couple months? Well, that's what we're going to talk about on today's show. In fact, I like to call this calming scanxiety without medications. Hi, I'm Carol Ricard, and I am the new host of the TV show, I Am Not Cancer. And before we get started on what we're going to talk about today, I just wanted to share just a little bit about myself and the reason that I started this show. Because truthfully, in October of 2019, I was diagnosed with cancer. And then in November of 2019, ended up having surgery. And then in December, finding out that that cancer had spread and was now stage 3, and I needed to do chemotherapy and radiation. And so that's what I've been on, is this cancer journey. Now, I have a little bit of an advantage though, because for 30 years, I've actually taught stress management in hospitals. And truthfully, I felt like God gave me this little assignment. And so that is what we are doing here today, is I'm going to share with you all the tools that I use during my cancer journey. Now, the other important part about this show is that it really has a mission to inspire, to inform, and to empower you. And I really believe that we are not defined by what the circumstances are in our lives. So, getting on with today's show, I pick this as our first sort of teaching show to do, because let's face it, scanxiety is a real thing. And I myself was actually able to keep my anxiety levels down really, really pretty low around these cancer scans. So to understand how these tools are going to work, I want to introduce you to the easiest way that I kind of get people to think about stress. And that is this: a bottle of root beer. So if you take a bottle of root beer and you end up shaking it up, right, the pressure actually builds up inside. And you'll notice there's a little bit of foam, and no, I'm not going to open it. In fact, it's duct tape, because when I would do this in live workshops, I actually had people open it. So I duct tape all my bottles now. Anyways, think about people are just like a bottle of root beer. And what ends up happening is that life shakes us up. And that pressure starts from the minute we wake up in the morning, and it just builds and 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 builds. And what usually ends up happening to most people is they're not paying attention to kind of the signs that their brain is telling them that you're stressed out. And they don't end up recognizing it until one of two things. Either one, it spills out. And I'm sure you've had that happen to you with a bottle that was carbonated. Could be soda, could be seltzer. Or what ends up happening is that people actually implode, meaning that they are the ones that get sick. It doesn't come spilling out on the wrong people. It just stays in and makes them sick. And the research is really clear that stress is not good for cancer patients. All right. Research has shown two things. One, that stress can actually interfere with treatment outcomes. And it has also been shown that stress can cause cancer to even spread faster. So that's going to be the mission when it comes to teaching of this show. But today, what I really want to just focus on is the stress that's connected to having to go for any type of scans. And the secret to this, just so you understand, is it the way that we start to manage this so it doesn't spill out, is that we, one, have to stop shaking the bottle, right? And two, we got to release some. So we go and let a little bit out. And that's the same thing with the tools that we want to use when we're trying to manage our stress. So that brings me to the first tool that I would like to share with you all. And that happens to be a tool that I call stress kryptonite. Now, you know that kryptonite can take out Superman faster than a speeding bullet. Well, this has the power to take out stress faster than a speeding bullet. So what is it? Well, quite simply, it's oxygen. So have you ever heard that belly breathing or yoga breathing or diaphragmatic breathing that they teach women when they're, you know, they're pregnant, that it's good for your health? Well, the reason is because you are getting some oxygen in to your belly. And here's why that's important. I want you to do this experiment with me. I gotta be careful not to hit my mic. I want you to put one hand on your chest. I want you to put one hand on your stomach. And on the count of three, I want you to take a breath. All right? And notice which hand moves. Are you ready? One, two, three, breathe. All right, we're going to do that again, just in case you're like, I couldn't tell which one it was. Are you ready? One, two, three, breathe. Now, here's the bad news. If the hand on your chest is what moved, that will not work for stress kryptonite. If you took a breath and your belly actually moved, that will work for stress kryptonite. And here's the reason why. When we breathe and take a deep breath, it gets into the bottom part of our lungs. And I call it the loading dock. And what happens is, in the bottom part of our lungs, that is where the most oxygen actually gets into the bloodstream. And then from there, it goes to your whole body, but more importantly, it goes to your brain. And so that's the secret why belly breathing and yoga breathing is so good for our health, because we're actually getting more oxygen into our body, more oxygen into the bloodstream, and so that it's getting the places that it needs to go. So what I want to do is have you put your hand back on your chest and on your belly again. And this time I want you to concentrate and just try as you breathe in to make your hand on your belly actually move. All right? Ready? One, two, three, breathe. All right, we're going to try it again. On the count of three, I'm going to say breathe. One, two, three, breathe. Okay, now, here's the thing. Don't panic if you didn't get it, because it's going to take some practice, all right? But the good news is that we were all born belly breathers. In fact, watch a baby sleep and notice what moves on them when they're breathing. It's not their chest. You watch a baby sleep, it's their belly. Now, so we were all born belly breathers. Now, my theory is, although I have no science and no research to back it up, but that I changed, at least myself, when I wanted my clothes to fit me a little bit better, right? So my pants, I didn't want them to be tight, so I was like, and then I brought that air up here into the top part of my lungs so that my pants would fit me better. But again, I have no theory. But I wanted to give you a great visual of what this is. So I brought my handy dandy little ball with me. And what this is it, I want to show you. So when you're a chest breather, this is how much oxygen you're actually getting into your lungs, all right? You're getting a little bit in there. You're getting enough in there to keep you alive and everything running. But watch what happens when you do a belly breath. This is how much oxygen you're actually getting in to your body and to your brain with that belly breathing. So the secret to stress kryptonite is that you use it several times throughout the day. But more importantly, that when you are going in for your scan, so I have to do CAT scan, and I have to do a CAT scan that actually has a dye that goes through me. And you know, a CAT scan isn't as bad as an MRI, because I've had one of those too. And that's where they kind of close you in that little tube, and you're really sort of kind of closed in there. And one of the things that I used to do, and I want to encourage you to do, is this belly breathing, all right? And actually, that's the best way to practice. So when you go to bed at night, what I want you to do is lay down, and I want you to put a hand on your belly and put a hand on your chest. And as you breathe, I want you to try and make the hand that's on your belly move so that you see that go. You could put a book there, you could put anything there. But one other thing you could put there is there are some apps that you could download, and they go for an Android or an iPhone. I want to say that Belly Bio is one of the apps that I've learned about, and there was another one which was I Breathe Relax, I think. But you could do a little Google search, say apps, breathing apps for your phone. But what we want is one that's going to measure when your stomach moves, all right? Because that's what we're having to retrain ourselves to do, all right? So that is tool number one for anxiety. And I want you to use it every single day, several times a day, but more importantly, when you're having your scan actually being done, I want you to make sure that you're doing your belly breathing. That brings us to the next couple tools I want to share with you all, and that means I got to stand up and I'm going to kind of come over to my board, all right? Now, I'm going to make sure I don't trip over things. All right. So you guys should be looking at me through this little camera right there. So what happens is scans is that there are two places that people will actually get lost, right? One is in the Y. I call it the Y me's. All right. The other place that we can sometimes get lost, and your brain hijacks you there, is what I call the what ifs. All right. And I gotta be honest with you all, I struggled. I struggled with this the moment my surgery was set. My brain would kind of go to one of these two places. More so this place over here. Because it was like, what if the surgery doesn't work? What if I don't come home from the surgery? I remember having that thought when I was sitting at my desk, right? And I knew I had to come up with a couple new tools. So the first tool I came up with was what I call a now anchor. And I want to write this down for y'all. So the word now, and what now stands for is, actually, let me go ahead and write it here. Notice only what is. Okay. So that's the same. But what I did was I went out and I grabbed some rocks from my front yard. All right. And I had a couple, I just had a couple little rocks. All right. And then what I did was I took a magic marker and I wrote the word now on them in a magic marker. Then what I would do is I would keep this in my pocket, and when I would catch myself getting lost in either the what ifs or the why me's, I would reach in my pocket, hold my anchor, and say, notice only what is. And immediately I would kind of be anchored back to the present moment. So it's using it just like a boat would use an anchor to sort of keep it steady. What I wanted to do is try and keep myself steady in the moment so that I didn't get swept away to the past and I didn't get swept away to the future. Now, I realized that not everybody has access to these sort of little stones. So The other thing you can do is you could take some quarters, and I'm kind of upset because I forgot them at home, so I don't have them to show to you. But what I did was I took four quarters, or you can use nickels, and I took four of them and I taped them together. Then I took a little piece of paper, ripped a little piece of paper, and I wrote the word now on it, and I taped it around those quarters. And I could have that in my pocket as my now anchor, all right? But even if you can't do that, there's one other thing that we can all do usually with what we have at home. And that is you just take a piece of paper, all right? In this case, I took an index card, and you want to write the word now on it. And then what you do is you fold it up and you can hold it in your pocket, all right? And when you catch yourself starting to kind of get hijacked away, you say to yourself out loud, notice only what is. In fact, you could say your first name. So I would say to myself, Carol, notice only what is. And I would immediately sort of anchor myself back. What I want to do is share with you all what I actually came up with, this tool working with my patients, because they would be going to, like, say, I had a woman going one time for a custody hearing, and she was trying to get custody of her daughter, and her husband was fighting her for it. And so what I did was I grabbed an index card and I just wrote real quick on there, we are with you. And then of course we all put our initials on it. And then I told her, because she didn't have any pockets, I actually told her, you know, to take this, and she could tuck it inside of her pants if she needed to, or I actually had one patient, no lie, who tucked it inside of her brassiere, you know. But when she needed the support, she could just go back to that card. So that's Scanxiety tool number two, which I call the now anchor. Now, the now anchor. So there's one other tool that I used that really helped me with these what ifs and the why me's. And that is, if I didn't have clothes on, I didn't have my pocket, I didn't have my stone on me, the other thing you can do just with nothing is just to say to yourself, feel your feet. And what's really amazing, so I want you to do that right now, all right? I'm just going to say that. You notice what happens. Feel your feet. Well, all of a sudden, your attention goes down to your feet. And so again, you're not lost in your head and hijacked by the thoughts, but you're actually focusing those thoughts more on your feet, if that makes sense. And that works because we can't focus on two different things at the same time, all right? And the thing I also want to just get you to thinking about is having a little stress ball with you as you're going to your appointment, all right? If you have somebody there that you can talk to, you know, now that the restrictions are kind of lessening, but I know where I go for my treatment, they still are limiting and not allowing any visitors. So the last time I was there for my scan, just last month, I couldn't have anybody with me. The idea of this, though, is that remember I told you that we want to do something to stop the level from rising, but then we also have to do something to release what's there. Because that bottle, if I go get that bottle over there, the pressure hasn't gone anywhere. What I put in there is still in there, and it will stay in there until I release it. The same thing happens with stress. When our stress starts to pile up and it raises and raises and raises, we can do breathing and that stops it. The problem though is that what's the next thing that's going to come along until then you end up either exploding or imploding, meaning it spills out, or you end up getting sick. And so the second part is you want to have something that you can do, all right? In this case, I will take my little stress ball with me, and you need to do your breathing, right? And then just have this as your release. Now, there's another way I like to use this stress ball, but because we're just talking about going for any kind of scan right now, I'm going to keep it to just this use. And that is, you can actually have this. Now, I don't think they would have actually let me had this in my CAT scan, right? But I tell you what, as I'm walking down the hallway and I'm getting changed, this baby is going to be with me, you know, every step of the way, all right? But I actually didn't try to take it into the scan with me. And so I don't know. I don't know if they'd let me do that. So that is Scanxiety tool number, four, right? Because we talked about breathing. Stress kryptonite is stress anxiety tool number one. Scanxiety tool number two is the now anchors. So you end up having this. Scanxiety tool number three is the feel your feet. And then this becomes Scanxiety tool number four, which is to just create that release so that as that pressure's coming up, you're also dumping it, all right? So that's there. And then that brings me to the last, okay, stay right there. That brings me to the last kind of tool that I'd like to share with you. And that is, let's get a new paper here. A special kind of breathing technique. Now, this is called square breathing. And truthfully, you can do it as a belly breath or you can just do it as a regular breath, okay? I don't want to stress you out more while you're trying to do this. But here's how it goes. I'm going to breathe in, and in my head, I'm counting 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I want to pause and I want to count in my head 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I want to pause and I'm going to count in my head 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm going to pause again 1, 2, 3, 4. And I want to draw this for you so you'll understand why they call it scare. Yeah, they call it scare breathing. No, they call it square breathing. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to breathe in and we're just going to count 1, 2, 3, 4. So here's in. Then I told you I want you to pause and to count 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we're going to exhale. So out, and we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. And then the pause. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is why they actually call it square breathing. I've heard people call it box breathing in the past. The idea of it is, and let's write this over here. So pause, pause. There's two things and two things at work here. One is that you're getting oxygen in, right? Two though, is that by using your brain and having to count the numbers, you're actually again directing your mind to something rather than letting it just get hijacked by the fear or the worry or the overwhelm that you might be feeling, all right? So again, it's in, counting to four, pause, counting to four, out, counting to four, and then pause, counting to four. So what I'd like to do is I wanna guide you through this a couple times, all right? And I want you to say the numbers with me. I'm going to say them out loud, but I want you to also say them in your own head as we do this. Are you ready to get started? So sit comfortable, okay? Make sure you're not driving or anything like that. Okay, so you're going to breathe in and count 1, 2, 3, 4. Pause, 1, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 1, 2, 3, 4. And pause, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, how was that for you? again, by making it be a belly breath, we can actually end up getting more oxygen into our system. So that's the five tools, and I'm going to come back and sit down now. So make sure, again, I don't trip over my kind of thing. So let's do just a really quick review, right? We got to take steps to manage that anxiety, because it's just going to keep building in us until it either explodes or we implode. And the tools that I shared with you all were, one, your belly breathing, right? And that we want to make sure that we get this amount of oxygen going to our brain so that we can neutralize that stress response. Then we also talked about a now anchor, or just using quite simply a piece of paper that has the word now on it. And we notice only what is. The other tool then was the feel your feet, right? And so you just want to actually just say to yourself anytime, anywhere, feel your feet. And then we talked about your stress ball, because you got to have something in there for the release, all right? And lastly, we talked about the square breathing. So my hope is that this has served you well. You're going to find my information that's going to pop up for you to see. And what I'd really love for you to do is to email me, to join our Facebook group, to like us, you know, to share with people these tools and these resources. And also, let me know what some of your concerns or things that you need help with, because that's what I want to make sure that this show does moving forward. So I thank you so very much for joining me, and I'll see you on the next show.